Well, good morning, everybody. I hope that you're doing well as can be expected. Since we're not able to meet together as a church family, I hope that you're watching online on Sunday mornings. But I decided that I wanted to have just a little more contact with you. And so, at least for the next month or so, I'm going to be posting a devotion on my Facebook page Monday through Thursday. I just want to share some thoughts with you as we go through this incredibly just weird and frankly difficult time. And even before this latest thing, some of you were already thinking, how are we going to get through this? How am I going to get through this? Maybe you were dealing with other pressures and other things in your life that you didn't even know how you were going to make it through that. And now on top of all that, we have all of this stuff. Maybe you were struggling already with financial issues or marriage issues, or maybe you've been really worried about a child or some health issues, or worried about your parents, or just all kinds of stresses that come on you. And listen, if you are in the healthcare field, if you're a healthcare worker, mental health worker, anybody working in doctor's office or hospitals, so those of you especially that are part of our First Church family, you just know that I'm praying for you. I know who you are. I know who all of you are who work in those fields, and I'm just praying for you during this very, very difficult time. But the question, how do we get through this? And I want to throw just one word at you this morning, and it's just a simple word: perseverance. Perseverance. That's how we're going to get through this. Several years ago, I think it was about 9 years ago, Max Lucado wrote a great book, and of course it's a great book because it's Max Lucado, right? But even though he wrote this book 9 years ago, I think it's really a book that he wrote for such a time as this. And it's a book called You'll Get Through This. You'll Get Through This. We studied through this book in my Sunday school class several years ago. Some of you remember doing that. But in this book, You'll Get Through This, he kind of holds this mantra out there. And a mantra is just kind of a saying that you keep repeating because it's something that you need to hear. And so throughout this book, which I highly recommend, Hope and Help for Turbulent Times is the subtitle. But You'll Get Through This. I highly recommend this book by Max Lucado. But when we were studying this book with our class anyway, we would say this mantra at the beginning, at the end of every class session. And it simply is this, and I would just encourage you to think about this and to repeat it and maybe even to memorize it. It says, you'll get through this. It won't be painless and it won't be quick, but God will use this mess for good. In the meantime, don't be foolish and don't be naive, but don't despair either. With God's help, you'll get through this. You'll get through this. It won't be painless. It won't be quick. Like, we know that even already. But God will use this mess for good. And this is a theme throughout the entire Bible, that God uses things that are broken and seem to be a mess. He uses them for good. And he uses them to make us better people. God will use this mess for good, but in the meantime, don't be foolish and don't be naive. There are a lot of people out there that want to take advantage of people when they're in a state of fear and anxiety. So don't be naive and don't be foolish, but then it says don't despair. Don't despair. With God's help, you'll get through this, and you will. You'll get through this. Persevere. Persevere. I think of the great passage from Hebrews 12, which says, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin which so easily entangles. And then it says, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. And then it goes on to say, how do we do this? Well, we take it one day at a time. We trust God. But then it says we also keep our eye focused on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him, it says, endured the cross. So we're to persevere in this race, however it looks, however challenging it might be, because we set our eyes on Jesus, who persevered and endured the pain of the cross for us. And listen, friends, if Jesus can endure the pain of the cross, if he can persevere, then we can as well, because we have his strength within us. And that would be my prayer for you today, that you would persevere, that you would rely on the power that comes from God, and that you would put one foot in front of the other, take it one day at a time, and don't worry about tomorrow, but just thank him and praise him for today. The great Christian many years ago, St. Augustine, one of the great early Christians, said, God, you have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they rest in you. God, you have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they rest in you. So that would be my prayer for you today, that your heart would rest in God.